This is Accurate TV News,
where you get your news on time.
Six Jamaican lawmakers under probe for alleged illicit enrichment. The Integrity Commission is reporting that six parliamentarians are being investigated for illicit enrichment. At the same time, the commission is reporting that seven lawmakers are now being probed for providing false information to the anti-corruption body. The alleged breaches have been set out in the Integrity Commission's annual report, which was tabled in Parliament Tuesday afternoon. Section 14(5A) and B of the Corruption Prevention Act state that illicit enrichment happens where a public servant owns asset disproportioned to his lawful earnings, and upon being requested by the commission of any person duly authorized to investigate an allegation of corruption against him to provide an explanation as to how he came by such assets. He fails to do so or gives an explanation which is not considered to be satisfactory, he shall be liable to prosecution for the offence of illicit enrichment. The law states that it shall be a defence to a person charged with an offence of illicit enrichment to show the court that he came by the asset by lawful means. The commission did not name the lawmakers. It also did not indicate whether they are from the Senate or House of Representatives. The commission also reported that 77 of 84 parliamentarians who were required to file a statutory declaration submitted information on their assets, income and liabilities on or before March 31, 2023. Following the deadline date, four parliamentarians submitted their statutory declarations and three remain outstanding. Of the three that remain outstanding, two are from the lower house and one from the Senate. Escapee recaptured in St. Catherine. A man who escaped the Ocherius lockup in St. Anne in August 2022 was recaptured in Christian Gardens, Gregory Park, St. Catherine on Tuesday. He is 33-year-old Jermaine Rogers of Miles End, Ocherius. He was previously charged with illegal possession of firearm. Rogers was among four men who escaped custody in Ocherius on August 5, 2022. He was returned to custody and is awaiting his court date. Killer in Low Garwood murder case reportedly paid $170,000. The first witness at the trial of Javon Garwood for his stepmother's murder in Trelawney Church has told the court that the man who pulled the trigger, Dwight Bingham, told him he was paid $170,000 to do a job. The witness, Leon Hines, was the getaway driver in the murder and is serving a 6-year sentence after pleading guilty for his part in the crime. Bingham has also pleaded guilty and is awaiting sentence for murder. Hines told the Trelawney Circuit Court this afternoon the series of activities leading up to the murder of Low Garwood in the Agape Christian Fellowship Church on January 31, 2021. Hines said on January 26 he got a WhatsApp message from Bingham saying that he got $170,000 to do a job. I thought that it was to do some construction work because I know that he was into construction work, he told the court. I rented a car on the 29th of January 2021. I was approached by Prince Bingham to transport him to Falmouth on Sunday. At that time, I did not know for what reason, he further told the court. He said when he arrived at the church, he parked in a lane beside the building. I saw Prince exit the car with a black pouch and a gun in his waist. Shortly after, I heard five explosions and Prince walked out the church and instructed me to burn road. Shortly after, he realized his phone was missing. He did not take up my offer to go back and look for the phone, Hines related. On the journey back to Rose Heights in Montego Bay, Bingham reportedly tried to make several calls using Hines' phone. At one point, he said, the one Janoy not answering his phone. When asked to look around the courtroom to see if he could recognize Janoy, he pointed out Javon Garwood, who was sitting in the dock. The trial will resume tomorrow. Motorists warned to expect delay in sections of Lucy, the National Works Agency NWA is advising that motorists may experience delays along Seaview Drive in Lucy and over on Wednesday. The agency says it will be carrying out works to asphalt a section of the roadway in the vicinity of the Lucy Seventh-day Adventist Church. Community Relations Officer for the NWA's Western Region, Janelle Ricketts, says the work will result in section of the roadway being periodically reduced to a single lane access. The NWA earlier replaced a defective culvert which had undermined a section of the heavily used corridor. Motorists are being reminded to obey the post-warning signs and the instruction of flag persons.
Don't forget to subscribe to Accurate TV News. If you don't do it already, you can do it now.